ninjas, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I'm Ayada Karate here with Dummy and Dumber. Let's get it. Well, this video we're gonna be ranting or talking about.
You wanna start it off?
You guys are gonna heat it. What don't you guys like about our relationship?
Man, when I'm walking out in public and you right beside me, you don't have to be hugged up on me all the time. Give me some space, like I like my personal space. You all pull my hip and all on me talking about baby this and baby that. Like, get off me. Like, I'm chilling. I'm trying to have a nice conversation and walk you all up on me. I can't stand that shit. I can't stand it at all. That clingy shit is just.
I don't like it when they always assuming shit. They always assuming stuff. See, they listen up with all these other random people, not their friends, but random people say about me or something else. And they automatically think that's the truth. It is not. People talk. And that's how rumors start. And sometimes rumors are lies. So that's what I gotta say. Don't believe anything you hear.
Right when I don't want to talk, whenever.
I'm not gonna blow your phone up. I can't even double text. So I damn sure.
And then I hate dry texters. Am I the only one that hate dry texters?
Yeah, I hate dry texters.
No, I'm a dry texter myself.
So you're just like, fuck it. I'm a dry texter, so I would want a dry texter.
No, it depends. It depends on who it is that I'm dry texting.
Like, if it's a girl you really like.
Oh, it's gonna be a very moist conversation. Like,
He said it's gonna be a very moist conversation.
It's gonna have substance. But if I'm just hollering at you or whatever, don't expect too much. You might get an emoji every now and then, but everything else is like 1 to 2 sentences.
Savage.
It's
like me saying, what are you doing?
Nothing. Texting you.
No. Technically, that's answering your question.
That doesn't be like that.
But like what? What do you mean?
I'd be like, shit, I'm chilling. I'll tell you what I'm doing. I'd be like, what you doing? I don't even like the WID shit no more. Like, I'd be like, what you about to get into? What you getting into? You good? That kind of shit. I can't. It's the difference between dry and I just don't like typing on this shit. You
know what I'm saying? What about you, Terry?
Shit. It depends what mood I'm in. That's all it depends. I really can't say. It just it depends.
Shit. Alright, I got another question. Alright, do you guys like it when, like, let's say you're dating a girl and y'all have a problem and she goes and tells her friend?
That's a major fucking problem, because friends always, here's the thing, friends always, especially when it comes to female friends always be the one to be like, oh, that nigga ain't shit, no. Like, no, talk to some people who are going to help you out. Now, that can be one friend, but not a whole bunch of friends. Find that one friend. This for the ladies out there, you got a problem, find that one friend. Don't be getting a whole bunch of your friends, y'all go to y'all's place, y'all pour some wine, and y'all talk about niggas all fucking night, about problems and shit. No, talk to one person, figure out how you can settle things before the relationship gets worse. That's all I gotta say.
What about you, mister?
This is the thing. Talking to somebody else about a problem between me and you is not gonna get the problem between me and you fixed. You gotta talk to me about that shit. Like, I can't.
True.
I can't. If I don't know what the fuck is going on, and you telling somebody else, how can I fix what the problem is? That's why I can't. Say this shit to my face first so we can talk about it. Then after that shit's over with, you can go tell your friend, keep it this, and then I don't know what to do, ask for advice, but if you really gonna talk about that shit, to me first, one-on-one. They not in a relationship, we're in a relationship. Keep them off of
it. They always want to put other people in the relationship, it's just two people.
That's how feelings get hurt.
Y'all boring.
I'm trying to figure out what is the most annoying thing a nigga can do?
Yeah, that's all I want to know.
It's like, hold on, let me see.
Most annoying thing.
What do you hate about dudes? What's the one thing you hate about dudes?
Alright, okay, there's an extent, okay? I get y'all are trying to get to know a person and shit. Mm-hmm. But, like, if I don't know you and you ask for my number randomly, you know what I mean? You're one of many niggas that just ask for my number randomly, you feel me? Mm-hmm. And if you guys don't try to, like, make it known that you guys are, like, different in a way, I won't text you back. You feel me?
But see, here's the thing. That's the reason why you're gonna talk to you.
No, okay, I get that. But then there's some niggas that don't get it. And well, then I just blow your phone and you don't even know them yet. Type shit. You feel me? That shit's annoying.
I understand what you mean.
Like, you blowing up my phone and I don't even know you yet. Or calling right off the bat. Like, you feel me?
So how is that good to get to know me?
Well, you could ask to hang out. Like, I don't know. Like, if we were on campuses, let's say you met me at the marketplace or some shit.
Yeah, that's different. There's steps you gotta take. If you meet somebody someplace, you know you're gonna see them again.
Yeah, but like, I don't know, like, that should be Aggie. I don't know, that's just me.
I got you.
Like, if you know you're gonna see them again, you know what I mean?
Okay, yeah.
Like, when you meet them, have a conversation with them first. Instead of just asking for the number and then walking away, you feel me? Mm-hmm. Like, at least have a 15-minute conversation with me, get to know me, and if I feel comfortable enough with you, I'll be like, oh shit, he was cool. I think we have a lot of shit in common. And I fuck with it, so I'm gonna keep texting you. But if you just ask for my number and then like leave, I'm gonna be like, that nigga didn't try hard enough. I don't want to text him type shit. That makes sense.
I got you.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
I got you. I understand what you're saying.
Yeah, because that should be accurate. Like, how are you gonna ask my number and then leave? And I don't even know your name. Or like, you did tell me your name, but then I'm like, you didn't ask for my name. It's like some weird shit. I mean, y'all weird with that shit.
Ooh, I got another question.
What?
This is your person. Like, alright, so if I'm like on Twitter or Instagram or whatever, you know how niggas be DM'd out and that shit.
Yeah.
I'ma shoot my shot and I'ma shoot this shit wild. Like, I'ma say some off the wall shit. I'm trying to figure out what works. Cause I'ma throw some shit that you go look at and be like, what the fuck is this that you're talking about? Like,
what type of shit you be saying to a girl?
I'd be throwing shit like, I'd be like, God sent you for me and shit. Like,
oh my god, bro.
I got some shit that I know works for sure, but like when I'm just like shooting my shit because I don't know if I'm gonna make it or not, and I just want to see if that shit'll work, I'm gonna hit you with some God sent you for me, all this other shit. Like, I just don't know how that shit
works.
You're
using like the corniest pickup lines that we know that you use on every other girl type shit.
No. Everything I use for different. No.
No.
I use different. Every girl that I shoot off at gets a different message. If that makes sense. Like, I can't say
the same lines to the same a different girl.
Mm-mm.
So you how do you figure out what works for them then?
Oh no, you just try shit.
You just try a different thing for each girl. So.
You're weird, my nigga's ass.
No, so say like.
No, like I gotta. If so I say the thing over and over again, I never know if it works. I gotta shoot different shit and see what falls.
It's like when you go talk to a female, so you wanna start up a random conversation or you be like, hey. You cute, or hey, that ass is fat, you know? Now, no one's really gonna do that, but it's
they
two different.
To me.
It's different.
Look, I know one guy caught my attention one time because I was in the marketplace, and he deadass walked by me, and he looked at me like if he like never seen me before. This thing was to the corniest shit, but the deadass caught my attention. Like, I remember him. Does that make sense? Like, he just walked by me, and he was like, hey, girlfriend, what are we going out tonight? I'm like, what the fuck?
That sounds very picky.
But it was cute. Like, if you would have seen it, like, you know, it's like something that you'd be like, he's
right.
The only type of
yeah.
person that would say
yeah,
something
yeah,
like that. Like, yo, that's. That nigga that ass did something different. Like, you feel me? Like, it makes you remember them. Like, you have to leave an impression on them.
I mean, it's corny, but like you said, I
remember him because of that. Like, every time I see him, I'd be like, that nigga got some. I need to figure out what the fuck he's about because he tried.
Yeah.
He did it different. I don't know how to explain it.
It makes sense.
Maybe that's why it works because you're doing something different. Because usually girls, like, if you know they're bad and they're getting hollered at a lot, they're not going to reply to a text unless they feel like, oh shit, he did something different.
Yeah.
It wasn't basic.
Mm-hmm.
I got you. It's easier in person.
Okay.
Yeah, it is easier. Awesome. Like, if you try it through the internet, I bet I can reply.
So you rather do talk to him face to face?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's easier that way anyway.
Yeah, it is easier that way. Because this way I get used to you, I feel more comfortable. And then when you ask me to chill, I'll actually go chill with you. But if you just like ask me to chill and I never actually interact with you like that, I'm gonna be like, nah, you're tweaking because I don't feel comfortable with it.
I got you.
Plus, I feel like you don't get, depending on what niggas say, like, you can't get all the emotions of what they're saying through, like, a message. But, like, in person, you can see, like, what their vibe is and all that shit. And
their body language and everything.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Now, there's some dudes who just can't talk face-to-face. That's why they gotta use the internet. I have a question.
Yeah.
Do y'all females like it when a dude talks to you when you're by yourself or when you're with your friends?
It's both.
Like you're asking
me what you're doing. No, it's like, if you talk to us when you're with our friends, it's a plus because, like, they get a vibe off of you. So, okay, if I'm with a group of girls and you just come up and approach me and you're vibing with us, afterwards you're gonna be like, oh my god, you should so holler at him because he's like da 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 and he's so sweet. You feel me? Like, I'm getting their input too.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like a good impression on you if it was good. But if it's by myself, I have to talk. Like, I will tell my friends how I met you and shit. But you know, if they were there, it would be an easier decision to make.
Yeah. So what are your own opinions and not?
Yeah, not my opinion. Like, they won't, you know, they won't eat off of mine and be like,
"Yours is original, not based off of yours."
Yeah. Like, it's better if you do it with the girls, because then they'll be like, "Yo, he's totally the one, bro. Like, yo, you should go on a date with him, talk to him, bro. Like, man, like, you know." They begin to get all up for no reason at all. I guess because they're your friends and just want to see you happy type shit, you know?
Right. There'll be some females that be like, "Nah, he's not good for you and stuff. How do your friends pick what you need?" You know what I'm saying?
Because our friends are like the ones that are with us all the time. You know what I mean?
True, but sometimes
they've seen what we've gone through, relationship-wise. I don't know how to explain it. It's just weird. Like, maybe they want happiness,
I guess, because I'm just saying, like, in my case, I was talking to this one female. Basically, she was going off of what her friend said, and not what she wanted, because she thought I was cute, so, but she went off of what her friends thought, and that pissed me off. I'm like, fuck what your friends think. Your friends think that every nigga is a certain way, but I'm not. You ain't never gonna see a dude like me. Ever. Ever. I'm that type of dude. So that's what I'm saying. So I'm just like, you listen, you feed into what your friends say instead of your own opinions, you know what I'm saying? So
hey, look, I'm gonna put my situation, like, look at it. If I would listen to my friends about a certain situation, none of that whole situation wouldn't have happened. Mm-hmm. But every girl's built differently. Like, some girls do listen to their friends, and there's girls like me that my mom taught me, like, don't listen to what your friends say because they just want what you have, you feel me? Mm-hmm. But if I would have listened to my friends, I wouldn't have put myself in that situation. You just learn off your experiences. Like, I see what you're talking about. You're not a bad person.
Right.
You know what I mean? So I see where, like, their friends are fucking up. But it's, you have to remember that the group you associate with says more than what you just say.
That's true.
Because remember, you know our squad.
That's true. And I understand that too, but I'm just saying, like, in some cases, you gotta admit that there are those friends who be like, "No, that dude's not good for you." You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But that dude can make her life better than some other dude. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That's all I'm saying.
That's true. That's true. Why not? But it's just like, the girl just has to make her own decision.
Right.
Some girls aren't really close to girls like that. Mm. Like me, I'm not really close to girls like that. So I really don't listen to other girls unless I really trust them. Mm-hmm. What? Bro,
you got so much energy. I don't know.
She does cocaine.
I don't do cocaine.
Whoa.
I wish.
Whoa.
wait, that goes the same thing for guys though.
What?
Like, you guys wouldn't date a girl that your friend says is a hoe?
Man, you have to understand, niggas, it's different between dudes. See, like, your dude's friend might say something about a girl, but usually the dudes won't care what the dude says, you know what I'm saying?
So, like, if your bro said that girl was a hoe, you would still fuck with her?
Do you not see all these niggas that fuck with hoes?
What niggas?
Niggas!
Look, he had a different answer.
Not all niggas, but it's like,
I don't know. I think we listen, but we know better. Like, if my nigga was like, "Nah, she's a hoe, bro." Like, "No, you don't want that?" I'm gonna be like, "No, I don't want that." That is like in a relationship thing, because if my nigga knows that she's a hoe and can show me the whole facts.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying, because sometimes they can say they hoes and they ain't really hoes, so we need to see the
like
facts.
If you can show me the hoe, like, tell me somebody she's been with, and if I know that he's been with her, he was like, "Yeah, she's a hoe," like, "Nah, I can't. I'm gonna fuck with you, but I'm not gonna, like, fuck with you heavy."
Yeah, I mean, I would be cool and stuff like that, but relationship, fuck no.
So there's there that's hoe facts. So there's a process for y'all to pick a girl?
Yeah.
No. I say hoe facts, like,
hoe facts, basically reasons of why she is a hoe.
Like,
so she fucked.
Okay, but let's say someone called me a hoe because of the girls I associated with, but I never did any hoe things. How would you guys?
See, that's the thing. We have to find out for ourselves. So
you would have a hoe facts. Like, okay, so like, I met this girl in Atlanta when I was down there for school. I met this girl and I was trying to find out, like, what her path was like, because didn't nobody really know her. So then my friend was like, "I'm gonna ask my nigga that goes to school up there. He would know who she is and all this stuff, so he could tell me the whole facts and stuff." I was like, "Cool." And when they got back and they was like, "Well, we know who she is. We can't name nobody she's done been with." I was like, "No, she can't be no hoe. Either that or she's undercover about it." And that's cool. But like, if somebody could come back and be like, "She done been with this nigga, that nigga, this nigga who we know got some shit.
Oh fuck.
Okay,
that's
gotcha.
A wrap. That's whole facts. Mm-hmm. We can't associate you by who you hang with, because y'all might just be friends, because y'all are friends. What they do on their private time, they don't really put you in their private time.
That's what I'm saying, but I heard someone that I say, you're a hoe because of the hoes you, your girls you hang out with.
Man, listen, if people want to use that hoe, the word hoe, like it's a damn, shit, I don't know what to say, how it's like, but they use that shit like every day, like, oh, she's a hoe. Oh, she didn't want to talk to me. She's a hoe. They're not all hoes. That's what they do, so I'm saying. So say if your best friend really was a hoe, say she really was, mm-hmm. and that's your friend, they're going to just assume, oh, damn, they cool with each other.
So
she got to be a hoe, too. That's not
association.
Yeah, so that's why, you know what I'm saying? But for me, see, just because you're hanging around with certain people, I ain't going to lie, if you hang around with certain people, you might be not really open to it, but like, you know it, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It might not bother you, you know what I'm saying? Because that's your friend, but that doesn't mean you a hoe. So that's why I got to get to know you, you know what I'm saying? I got to talk to you. I got to ask other people, hey, do you know any type of people she's been fucking with? And if no one can really say shit, and if you haven't told me shit, either you really low-key about it, or you really ain't hoeing.
Betty boo. What's up?
That's just facts and spitting, man. Like,
bro, I got another question.
What's up?
You guys like really girly girls, or do you guys like tomboys? Like, what is your preference?
Here's the thing with a tomboy. I mean, tomboy is a girl who's not afraid to get a little dirty with me. You know what I'm saying? So
yeah.
Like,
just think it's about it.
No.
I'm thinking you talking about like getting money, like
no, bro. Like a girl like who likes video games, you know what I'm saying? Who,
yeah, tell
me. Okay.
See what I'm saying? Because there's some girly girls who, if you try to kiss her, oh no, I just had this makeup on. Oh, don't kiss me right here. Kiss me right here. Oh, don't mess with my hair. I just got it done. Oh, I want to play video games with you. Oh, don't, like, I don't want no tomboy. I don't want no tomboy, like, that's trying to, like, a girl trying to be a boy. Like, fuck no. But I'm just saying, like, you know, don't be too much of a girl.
That's tough. It really is, because like, I really guess it just depends on like how we vibe or whatever. But I can't even do girly girls. I mean, not to mess with some girly girls, but I mean, that shit's boring. Like, I can't do what I want to do. And like, you're not going to do what I want to do because you too, what's the word, prissy? Is that a word?
Prissy? You mean you never heard the word prissy?
Prissy.
No.
I can't. But then again, like girly girls, people that wear all that makeup and stuff, I can't go for that neither. Mm-hmm. Like, if you have to use makeup to look good, I can't fuck with you like that. I like natural people. Mm-hmm. So like that girly girl part of that shit, gone. And then tomboy, you can't be too much like a nigga.
That's what I'm saying. You can't be too much.
But if you can think like a nigga and still act like a female, we probably gonna fall in love. Like, that's real shit. Like, that's real shit. If you can think like me, but act like a female,
it's a wrap.
Perfect. Mm-hmm. You know, like, I can't think of no better combination than that. We a tag team right there. LeBron and Kyrie were pretty much the Celtics like that. That's
us. Yeah, that's what I gotta say.
I guess this is a middle ground. Mm-hmm. Somebody who can do, get you a girl that can do both.
Yeah. There we go. Get you a girl that can do both.
That's what
there is girls like that too.
There are.
I'd be fine. I mean, I'm not struggling. I'm having a fuck with girls I really don't like, and I can't.
That's a personal problem.
It really is.
Wait on it.
I need
the time.
I won't
get the time.
I'm pretty sure you're only 19.
You're still 19,
you got like your whole life
put
span
up. I'm
going, you feel me?
Well, I ain't trying to find the one when I'm like
56,
though.
Why are you trying to find her so young, though?
I'm just trying to find, like, let me chill, because I'm not trying to find the one.
Like, bro, college is basically like high school.
Man, oh, yeah.
Nothing is right. Going to last. Like, high school relationships barely lasted.
I don't know. I've only ever been in two real relationships, and I only count one of them, and I don't even really count that one.
Like, I'm in two relationships, and I don't really count that one. I don't really count the other one, so he's been in there.
Yeah.
honestly.
I've only been in one real relationship that I consider a real relationship.
Man, what is... Oh, here's my question.
Because I hate getting hit with this shit and I don't know what to say back. When do y'all think it's okay to just say I love you and then expect me to say that shit back?
What do you mean?
Like...
Yeah, I don't know what to say either.
Well, here's what I think. It should be after a couple months because, you know, those are the
months. You just met the girl.
That's like, what I'm saying.
How would she love you?
That's what I'm saying. But that's what I'm saying. Like, you have to be like a good...
A girl tell you that she loves you really quickly like that?
A couple girls that, like, I don't know.
The girl.
I don't know. Usually I wait like a couple months. Alright, stop biting yourself, a fucking weirdo.
It's just how I think sometimes.
But no, like, I don't know how y'all can't just talk about it. Like, when y'all get done, like, what do we do good? Don't do it, like, directly after because that's weird, but, like, when you go home, because we're not with this thing tonight shit, but when you go home. And y'all text or whatever, just be like, well, I just need to know like what I did good, what I need to do better, so like your experience can be better. You know what I'm saying? If y'all don't talk about that kind of shit, you just gonna be poking and do whatever the fuck. And she might not like it, but she's not gonna tell you, you know, anything. That shit trash, because she gonna feel bad.
That ass.
So
I wouldn't tell you.
See, and I can't.
Like, unless you ask me about it, I wouldn't tell you. Like,
see?
Straight up. Mm-hmm.
And I can't go for it. Like, if I'm not doing this shit the way you like it, you gotta tell me so I can fix it. Because I gotta adapt to that shit. Like, I can't just... I hate going in doing some shit thinking I'm doing great and she's like, nah, this shit really not that good. That's gonna kill my ego. And I find out she talking about, she go to some other nigga talking about, yeah, nigga, that shit was trash. Like, I hated it. Tell me that shit. I can fix
it. Well, I'm not gonna tell anybody else about it.
I'm not saying that.
Yeah, I'll probably make sure y'all friends and be like, yeah, I just fucked. I don't know if y'all do that, but like, I just fucked this nigga. Like, that shit was okay, but I mean, it could have been better. Now tell me so I know what I need to do better. Mm-hmm. Tell me what you like. What you
don't be like, it's bad. Just be like, hey, we can just work on
this. If that shit trash, like, if that shit is bad, tell me and be blunt about it. Like, hurt my feelings so I have to redeem myself. That's how I feel. Like, I can't.
Tell me what to work out, dude.
Man, like, tell me, like, man, if you just do this shit, like, you're a little bit different. If you do this, like, a little bit more to this side type shit. Like, I'll be good, and that's what I'm gonna do. And I'm gonna work that shit. Like, I'm gonna make it work. If you can't tell me, like, if you cannot tell me I'm doing bad, I can't tell you you're doing good. That's how I feel. Like, I gotta have feedback. I mean, you fill my sex reports.
Have those applications in your room, like, you, let's take this home, bring it back to me tomorrow.
I just be like, I need a dick report. Like, tell me how my shit went. Like, what I did. What I did do better. So I can improve.
Some of these females be lying.
And that's the thing, I don't like being lied to. Like, if my shit is bad, that'll
be. They be lying, bro. Shit. Truth. Honesty is the best policy. Just tell the truth. You know, that's all I'm saying. Like, it's not just with sex, but like, if you really not feeling me, tell me I ain't feeling you, so I don't have to keep approaching you. So I can go on to the next female. Just tell me. Because I don't want to be wasting my time with a female. And you're giving me these mixed signs, but you will not really feel me because I'll pursue. And shit. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, give me, like, straight up, hey, you cool and all, but I don't really want to. We can be cool, but I don't want to fuck with you like that. Okay, I'm okay with being cool with you, but we don't have to fuck. Just let me know how you feel with me because I don't want to go through these days to a week and, like, you give me these mixed signals and shit. And next thing I know, you're fucking with some other nigga, and I'm just like, wait a minute.
Okay, time out. Okay, so this goes weird. How do we know that if y'all really are just talking to us? Like, okay, let's say we talk once in a while, but to me it's just like us talking. But you're really feeling me, you feel me? We just talking once in a while, but I'm feeling somebody else, but I don't know that you're feeling me. How does that work? Like, you know what I'm talking about?
Communication, yeah.
No,
communication.
But it's just like, some people that has to be like, yo, I was talking to her, but to me it didn't seem like we were talking.
Yeah.
Like, maybe they were kept feeling me, but I wasn't feeling them.
How about communication? Y'all gotta know if y'all are here, or if y'all are here or here, so y'all can fix it and be right here. You know what I'm saying? Because dude might think, oh, everything's going good. Like, we really don't talk. And she might think, hey, we just say hey from a couple of times.
Yeah.
Or the other way around. Communicate with each other so y'all can know. I know, because I fucked up a couple of times when it came to that. And I think, hey, we're really talking, but she's not thinking that. And that fucked me over. And so I had to adapt and I had to learn, okay, communicate with these girls. Communicate so you know what's going to happen. So you know, okay, she's not feeling me. Okay, she's not feeling me. Because I need to know this shit. I'm not going to put my good time in with you, and it's not going to be worthwhile. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
All I got to say.
Right, said, like, it's really about communication. Like, it's got to be a conversation that y'all have at some point before. Like, if he's really feeling you, he's got to be the one to be like, not like, I hate those what are we questions, but it's got to be like, like, where do you see this going? Like, because I'm really feeling you. I don't know if you're feeling me the same way I'm feeling you. If you're not cool, like, I'm going to fall back. We can still be friends and all this shit, but I'm going to go do my thing somewhere else. But if you is feeling me, we can go ahead and goddamn with this shit. But niggas, I think niggas just be scared to ask. They automatically assume that the female is feeling them as much as you're feeling. Wait, the female is feeling me as much as I'm feeling her. When that's 9 times out of 10, that's really not the case.
Yeah. Then I'd be finding out from weirdest people. Are you talking to this person? No, I'm not. Why? He's like, yo, he be seeing you talking to them. And I'm just like, I just said hi to him like a couple times.
Yeah. See,
it wasn't, to me, it wasn't like a whole, oh my god, my nigga, I'm best feeling this nigga's wife. Like, yeah. Oh shit. And he feel me that. But it just, I don't know, that should be weird.
That's a problem, man. Communication, man. People that like, can't communicate with each other. And don't get me wrong, it might be awkward at first to be have a one-on-one conversation with the person because you're afraid of what they're going to think.
No, that shit is weird.
It is weird, but at the same time, it needs to happen before hearts get broken and confusion starts to happen.
Thank you. It makes me feel like an asshole. Mm-hmm. If I'm not feeling you the way you feeling me, like, you, like, I'm feeling married, this nigga, like, I went ahead and be my boyfriend and shit, and I'm like, no, we just cool, but I got to talk over here, and I'm really trying to, like, get with it. I feel like a bad guy because I'm finna hurt your feelings really bad. Like, I can't. No, that's why you just gotta talk about it. Had that conversation, like, look, I'm really feeling you. What's good? That's like you gotta.
What's good?
What's good?
And if you're not feeling, and like, for females or for dudes out there, just tell your significant other, hey, if you're not feeling them or not. Don't be disrespectful, but just be honest about it, you know what I'm saying? Because.
She's like, no, like, I'm not really feeling you.
I mean, don't get me wrong. I mean, I used to be real sensitive when it came to that stuff, but like, I'd rather a female tell me, hey, it's not gonna work out than her giving me false hope. You know what I'm saying? So
that shit kills me.
That's what I'm saying. False hope, man. If you give me a little edge of it, what could happen, I'm gonna think, okay, I have a good chance. No, don't fuck the false hope shit. Can we work this out or can we not? That's all that needs to be said. And it doesn't, now the conversation doesn't need to end in a bad thing, because y'all get to be the best of friends, man. Y'all never know. But I'm just saying, like,
that's true. That's,
you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? You can end up being the best of friends. You don't have to be a relationship. I can have a good friendship. Who knows? Y'all might have that good.
Usually, there's type of relationship like you think y'all are compatible, mm-hmm. but y'all are better off just as friends. It's mm-hmm. just like something that happens.
No, don't get me wrong. Will it hurt that they might not like you back? You're damn right it will hurt. But at the same time,
it's better that you know that shit now
mm-hmm.
instead of getting surprised by that shit when you see her hugging up on some other nigga mm-hmm. and you looking like,
I know that shit, man. Yeah.
Okay, I don't know that shit.
It's ass.
All I'm saying is for y'all, communicate. That's what's wrong with our generation. We don't communicate. I'm talking about face to face, no phone shit, because
you can do this over text. You know, it's gonna hurt if you're the person that she can look you in your eyes and tell you, no, I'm not feeling you.
I feel like, but here's the thing though, because I feel like when it comes to text, people don't really believe in that. You know what I'm saying? Like, people when they text, they feel like, okay, what does that mean when they say that such and such? You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. If you do it face to face, then you know what kind of tone, kind of words they're using, instead of having to
what
be like, where they do something. Saying?
Yeah.
Even though, get me wrong, it's harder when it's face to face, but at the same time, you get the clear message out.
And
so,
you can tell they're lying because the eye contact.
Exactly.
Like, it's like,
with text, if they just.
All the people in their eyes when I talk, anyways, because the eye contact is weird to me. I can't look at somebody and they so.
I'll be thinking you lie 24/7.
But that's what I'm saying. Like,
you would never know if I'm lying anyway.
That's what I'm saying, though.
I'm just telling you.
Texting, like, you can be like, I don't think this might work. What does she mean? Is she saying that like, she's hesitant because she kind of wants to be with me, but it's not the right time?
Or
is she saying, like, see, that's what I'm saying. You've got to have if you have a face-to-face conversation, tell me everything I need to know, and we can be cool from there. Now, I'm not going to get pissed off at you. If you ain't feeling me, you ain't feeling me. That's the thing. Now, if you'd be like, hell no, I ain't fucking with you, then I might have to cuss you out when you say that shit. But like, you know what I mean? But if you just go up and be honest and you be good with it, shit. We can have that good friendship. That's all I gotta say.
Shit.
Communicate, man. There's nothing wrong with communication, man. Don't be scared. I mean, it's scary, but it's part of growing up, so.
Boom. But I think my battery's about to die, so I'll end this video.
The what?
Yeah. Well, that's all I gotta say for this video. Dumb and Dumber here.
I'm not dumb. I spit some knowledge for y'all.
The
so.
Series of the talk show.
Wow.
I'm gonna do a series like that, guys. A talk show series on my YouTube channel. But with different people, because this one has to go back to chat. So I'm pretty sure you guys are not gonna see him for a while until the next time he's back down here. So yeah. But probably we'll have a different person, and I don't know if Terry's supposed to do it again, but he'll probably gonna do this again. That's all I gotta say for my YouTube channel. Hope you guys like this video, comment down below, and then subscribe to this YouTube channel and follow them on whatever they're on.
Instagram, Snapchat, YouTube, all that stuff.
Pornhub. And that's all I gotta say for this video today. I'm Ayada Karate here. I hope you guys have a naughty, naughty, fantastic day. And I'm chopping y'all out of this video.